This video compiles some of the interesting situations arise during a mass simulation run of RoboCup logistics league.
During this lab course, the two competing teams managed to successfully develop their stable OpenPRS agents capable of completing all the production challenges with a strategy of their creation. This created a fierce competition between both teams, especially that the baseline they are competing against is the current world champion, the Cara Logistics team. Evaluate the agents, a mass simulation run of games was performed between the teams and the record holder. The team scored remarkably close against the current world champion.
Exploration phase. Team 1 divides their machines by column into groups of 3, while Team 2 divides them by rows. This static assignment approach was chosen because it does not require any coordination between teams' robots, hence eliminating the communication needed between the robots in the exploration phase. One of the optimization strategies that Team 2 used is that after the robots are done exploring, they go back to the starting position and wait for the production till the phase ends. This saves unnecessary traveling time consumed by Team 1 at the beginning of each production phase.
Production phase.
One major difference between both teams' strategies for production is that Team 1 never used localization-based approaches, which proved to be very effective for Team 2. A problem that happened often to Team 1 was because their robots released the locked machines directly after using it, while Team 2 was able to avoid that by releasing the machines only when the robots is on a safe distance far away from the machines. Here, the magenta highlighted Team Number 1's robot waiting for the insertion zone crashed into R2 before the latter gets the chance to leave the insertion zone. On the other side, Team Number 2's robot got away safely from the zone very easily.
Since the P3 product type is the most frequently placed order as well as the simplest to produce, teams took different strategies to guarantee the flow of a relatively simple score. Team 2 simply leaves the produced puck under the producing machine till shortly before an order delivery time begins. When the time is near, one of the robots is assigned the delivery task. On the other hand, Team 1 designated an area of the field to store their produced P3 pucks when there is no active orders, allowing them to keep a constant flow of P3 ready to be used when order time starts. This approach allows the successful delivery of orders with a short time gap between them. Even though the P2 has a complicated production process, their orders are usually placed relatively late in the game, making it the second easiest to produce. In this game, both teams completed the production before the order time starts, creating a scene where both delivering robots scan the field from end to end. P1 production is as complicated as P2, but their orders arrive much earlier in the game, making it the hardest to produce. Team 2 reliable coordination strategy impressively manages to finish the P1 production little over 5 minutes more than 90% of the time. To put that into perspective, this is almost half the average time needed by the current world champion to complete the production.